Good morning, children. Hope you understood what we had done in the last two classes. First, we had studied about the animal husbandry, the different kinds of management of farm and farm animals. Then we had gone into the plant breeding. Under plant breeding, we had studied what is plant breeding and what are the different methods in plant breeding. And also, then we had dealt about what are the various five different steps involved in plant breeding so that we can increase the productivity and the resistance of the plant towards various diseases, that is the pathogens like fungus, virus or bacterial diseases. And also we have studied that how it can be, the quality can be improved by bringing out various gene modification like in mutation breeding. Today we will be studying about how to increase, that is the plant resistance towards the insects. Okay, so that is the next topic which we are going to deal with, plant breeding for developing resistance to insects. Now you can see that the major problem for crop cultivation is nothing but the problem of insects. The large scale destruction of crops are done by the insects, various insects. You must have seen there are different insects, like there is stem borers, fruit borers, aphids, jesseeds. Then there are spiders also, various kinds of caterpillars. Then you have grasshoppers, which all will be infecting the crops, and thereby decreasing the destroying the crops to a larger extent. That's a major drawback for the farmers. So here we will be studying, now we are going to study what are the different methods to develop, that is for breeding plants to develop resistance towards the insects like spider or aphids or beetle. There are different varieties of beetles. You can see certain plants when it is growing, when it is about to flower, the flower itself or the bud itself is eaten away by the insects or by caterpillars or by grasshoppers. So for that case, we are going to study how to develop the resistance towards the insect. So there are certain plants which we can see, okay, around us, which has developed resistance towards the insect. So the resistance of certain white crops, you can see in the garden itself. So the plants which we want to grow, that takes a lot of time to take care of it, but towards the end you can see sometimes it will be infected by the insects. But at the same time, the wild varieties like the grass or other weeds which grow along with the plant, they grow very well. So what is the reason for that? So the reason for certain plants to have the resistance towards insects are, maybe it is due to the morphological feature. Morphological characteristics, or it may be due to some chemicals produced by the plants for biochemical reason. Okay, or it may be due to some physiological characteristics of the particular plant. Now, morphological means the certain plants have some adaptation. Like you can see in cactus, there are thorns, so some animals will not go for eating those cactus plants. Similar way, some of the wild varieties and all, the morphology, they have certain physiological or morphological factor. At the same time, some chemicals are produced by the plants in order to protect itself from being eaten away by the insect. So for example, in certain cotton plants, the leaves are hairy. Okay, hairy leaves in cotton plants. So the main insect which will be affecting the cotton plant is nothing but jesseeds. Okay, this insect, what happened because of the presence of the hairy leaves in that, so this cotton plant develops, it will be avoiding that plant, it won't be eaten away by jesseeds. Another example which you can see is in maize. Certain varieties of maize, it has high acid in it, that is biochemical reason, that is aspartic acid. Presence of high aspartic acid or high level, that is very less, low level of nitrogen in the plant. For these reason, what happens, certain insects and all will be like the soft fly and all will try to avoid this eating maize and all. Maize, which is of course very high rich in protein. Next, you can see in the case of wheat. Wheat, it has certain plants involved, it will have hollow stem. But wheat, certain varieties, due to its solid stem, what happened? The certain insects like soft fly or stem borers is another variety of insect which will be avoiding weed plant because of the presence of the solid stem. And in cotton plant also you can see there is another variety of cotton plant where the leaves are smooth. It has smooth leaves and then it also has it is nectarless, doesn't produce nectar. So when the flowers do not produce nectar, what happens? This will be avoided. Some worms which infect cotton plants, that will be avoided by certain worms known as boll worms. Right. So these are certain which is inbuilt in certain plants. It is there so that the plants can develop resistance towards the insect and they will not be affected, or they won't be insect man. Pest will not be infecting them. And even you can see the crop produced, rice or wheat or maize and all, which is being after the harvesting, when it is stored in a godown or this one, you can see that there are many, many small insects which will be pests which will affect the produce which are stored in the when after harvesting, when the crop produce are stored, even that those will be affected by the insects. Small insects and all. So all that we will be studying, that how this genes can be changed to develop a hybrid variety of the plant where the plants can develop resistance towards the insects. So here, for developing the resistance, first of all we should have the particular type of plants. So the plant can be obtained from, it can be present in the germplasm collection. That is, germplasm is nothing but collection of all different alleles of a plant, which will have a collection, very good collection of all the genes in it, which is required by the plant. So from the germplasm collection itself, we can get the source for breeding plants to develop resistance towards insects. So these are the source from which we can get the, we can modify the genes of the plant for developing a disease resistant or infect resistant plant. Next one, we can also get it from the cultivated crops. Okay, cultivated crops, or we can get from the wild varieties of the crop. All this we can be able to get the genes, or we can get genes for developing the resistance towards insect. Next, for this step, for example, there are many, many breeding and all which has been done, where hybrid varieties, a good quality of the parents, it is being selected from the germplasm and they are hybridized to produce a very well, that is a plant which gives high yield, at the same time it develops high resistance to insects. For example, the plants which are being developed, okay, or bred in India for developing resistance towards the insects are nothing but, you can see there is one plant, that is brassica, or it is nothing but mustard. Okay, the main thing is for developing resistance by this one certain insect, a white, that is the hybrid variety of plant of mustard is developed, that is known as Pusa Gaurav. Okay, it develops resistance towards the insect known as Jesseeds. Then you have the other variety, another example is flat bean. Flat bean, there are different hybrid varieties of the flat bean which is being produced. This infect which cannot be affected by the insects are Pusa Sem 1, Sem 2 and Pusa Sem 3. These two varieties, it will develop the resistance towards the insects. Towards which insects it will be developing the resistance? This is towards, it will develop resistance towards the seeds. This will be, and it also develops resistance towards the seeds. Then aphids, it's also an insect, and also it will be developing the resistance towards the fruit borers. Okay, so these are the plants which are developed for increasing the resistance of a plant towards the these insects by selecting the plant from the germplasm. Another variety you can see is nothing but okra. Okra is nothing but bhindi, or it is lady's finger. Lady's finger also, you have the variety which is being developed in India, that is Pusa Sawan. All these examples are very, very important which you have to learn. So this it will be, so lady's finger, what is the main thing when you grow a lady's finger in the house? If the stem may be infected by the insect, or the fruit also may be infected by the insect. So the insects which will be, which it develops resistance is fruit borer or the stem borer. So these example, Pusa borer is a variety of mustard or brassica, Pusa stem 2, Pusa stem 3, it is a the plant which is bred for developing resistance to insect, that is a variety of black bean, and Pusa Sawant is a variety of okra or lady's finger which develops resistance towards fruit borer and stem borer. Right. Next we will see plant breeding techniques. These examples are very, very important and can be asked in the multiple choice question. So next you can see that the other category is nothing but plant breeding for improved food quality. Improved food quality. So in the we know that large amount of crops are being cultivated, like wheat, rice, maize. There are many hybrid varieties and all present. But what happened, you can see that though so much of crops are being cultivated, there are many that is important nutrients which are not present in the food. That is, there are suppose some 840 million people are there. So they also, because of the large increasing population, the production of food also is very, very limited, and certain people, certain population of the people, they are not getting the important nutrients what is needed for their development. You must be knowing about the different nutrients and all which are not there, the minerals, that is some deficiency diseases, like you know that deficiency of vitamin A, which disease it leads to? Night blindness. Vitamin B, beriberi. Vitamin C, scurvy. Okay, so there are many important vitamins which are needed. At the same time, we need many important minerals. Minerals like we need little quantity of iron should be there in the food. Iodine, you know, have you heard about the iodized salt, Tata salt? You can see that on the cover it will be written iodized salt. And which is the major deficiency disease iodine causes? Yes, it causes goiter. So the people who are living in the hilly region and all, they have less amount of salt, iodine in it. So for that purpose, that is, iodine is being put into the salt, mixed with that, so that it increases the iodine content in the food. So the people who are suffering from goiter, so it prevents, it's a mainly prevention of goiter diseases. Next one, also iron, you know that the less amount of iron is mainly needed for developing hemoglobin or red blood cells and all. So if iron deficiency is there, it leads to anemia. Alright, so for improved, for increasing the different kind of nutrients in the food, there is another, that is plant breeding technique which is done for improving the food quality. And here also very important thing is, though there are, we all buy fruits, vegetables, legumes, rice, wheat, maize and all, but certain population of the people, because they are the poor people, they are malnourished, okay, they don't have important, that is, nutrients in their food, like vitamins, they lack in vitamins or they lack certain minerals in it. And it is nothing but, it is known as the term as hidden hunger. Though they are buying the food, but large amount they don't get the food. But in spite of them, those people who try to buy the food, they don't have important, the food content will not contain important food in it, that is nutrients in it. So it is known as hidden hunger. That is, the though in the food which we are consuming, they don't have important nutrients in it, the micronutrients or macronutrients or different kind of minerals in it, or it is lacking in proteins, carbohydrates, etc. Or they doesn't have fats in it, the essential fatty acids which are there in it for the development and all. And you can see in worldwide and all, small children and all, they are not having proper food. So what to do to prevent this hidden hunger? And this hidden hunger means there is a deficiency of important nutrients in the food which they eat. So how to prevent this? This can be prevented by developing the food, the crops which has high quantity of protein or carbohydrates or vitamins or fats or mineral in it. So that is the next which we'll be learning it. And if the food is not having proper nutrients or vitamins or minerals, what will happen? Yes, it will lead to the decrease in the lifespan. The mental abilities will be decreasing. It leads to various deficiency diseases, as I said. Okay, night blindness, beriberi or scurvy. So how to reduce all that? There is another important method that is which is being done for that is very, very important. It is known as biofortification. This is an important term. Now, biofortification is nothing but breeding crops which has high level of nutrient content in it. So it will be having high content of, that is, nutrients, breeding plants for increasing nutrients, important nutrients in it. Okay, nutrients like increased protein, vitamins, minerals and healthy fatty acids. Healthy fatty acids. You know that you can classify the nutrients under 5 categories. You have carbohydrates, then proteins, vitamins and minerals and fatty acids. And in that vitamins, minerals and all, you can again classify them as macronutrients and micronutrients. And there are different kinds of vitamins in it. So breeding plants for increasing nutrients like proteins, vitamins and minerals and healthy fatty acids in the food crop which we develop is known as biofortification. Very, very important term. Now, what are the main objectives? Okay, objectives of biofortification. The main objectives of biofortification is to increase or enhance the yield of what? That is to increase the protein content in the food. Protein content and quality. Okay, protein content and quality of protein in the food. Then to increase the vitamin content and quality in it. Vitamins, like you know that, vitamin A, you have vitamin B, C, then B12, etc. Vitamin D, do you know what is the main source of vitamin D? It's sunlight. Okay, so it prevents, which is the main deficiency disease which you get from sunlight due to lack of vitamin D deficiency. It's nothing but rickets. Alright, so in the objectives of biofortification is nothing but to increase the protein content, to increase vitamin contents in it, to increase the minerals in it, minerals which is macronutrients which is needed, minerals like iron, then calcium, then iodine. Okay, for example, then these are the various minerals which are needed in small quantities in our food, not in a, it's not considered as a macronutrients, micronutrients. So these, to increase the content of that, and lastly the main objective is nothing but to increase the fatty acid. Healthy fatty acids in the food. So these are the main objective for that and for developing in India. Many, many crops have been developed to enrich the food which is already been. The crops are developed by different method, either it is conventional method or mutation breeding or any other, but along with the food which we are eating, to increase the public health. Okay, so that they don't suffer from any deficiency disease. In India, many crops have been bred for, that is, breeding has been done for improving this quantity. So for example, which are the crops which are being bred for increasing the nutrition content of the food is, for example, you have, that is, a variety of wheat known as Atlas 66 has been developed, which has high quantity of protein in it. That is one example. So few examples here of it is very, very important. Next one, fortified iron. That is rice, which is fortified with iron, is also cultivated. Now, why you can see that there are different varieties of rice you must have seen around you. There are thick boiled rice, there are small raw rice and all which is available. Different names are there. But one more you must have seen, the red color rice. The red color rice has high content of rice in it. So that is also different varieties, especially in South India, in Kerala and all, you can see that people eat, they depend more on that red color rice. That is very, very important than the polished rice, because the husk itself, okay, the outer covering itself has high quantity of iron in it. So it increases the iron content by 3 times. Alright, so that has been developed, fortified rice. And then you can see that there are certain vegetables also which are being modified, which are developed for increasing the public health, that is to decrease the prevention of the deficiency diseases. So vegetables, certain vegetables like carrot, spinach and all are being developed so that it can, so which, what is it being enriched with? It is enriched with vitamin A. So that it develops, it gives the high quantity of vitamin in it. So carrot is there, carrot, spinach species are being bred by breeding technique, which has high quantity of vitamin A in it. Next you can see that there are different varieties of, that is another plant species, it is a batua, then tomato. Okay, bitter gourd is very, very important, very high in calcium and iron, bitter gourd. So it is bitter, but it has very high nutritional content in it. Batua, it looks like spinach, green leafy vegetable. Tomato, bitter gourd, etc. They are also being cultivated. And in that, what it is fortified with? It is fortified with vitamin C. So these are the different examples of the food varieties of crops which are being, to improve the food quality. Food, it is a crop, is being cultivated, but to increase the nutrient content in the food, these are the different varieties of food which has been cultivated to increase the public health. Alright, so that they don't suffer from any mineral deficiency or deficiency diseases which is caused due to vitamins or protein also. Certain, that is in the case of wheat, it is also this atlas, it has high quantity of protein. Maize is also developed, okay, maize is also developed which is having protein in it, but at least 5 times of protein has been increased by developing different varieties of maize. I hope you have, these examples are important, please learn it. Next we will see. Okay, so these are the different examples of the plant which have been bred for improved food qualities. So please go through the examples properly, it is very, very important. So next session we will see the remaining part of the, that is which are the different techniques to develop, which are the other things which are being added to develop to increase the productivity and to increase the food crops for ever increasing population of the world. So those two important we will be studying in the next session. Okay, thank you.